In this video, we are going to see how to create a report in the Web Report Designer. Assign it a JSON data source and use a complex field from the latter as a data source for the table inside the report. Let's start by creating a new report. Let's add the JSON data source from the Components tab. I have inline data already prepared and will copy it into the wizard. It has three main properties: the integer ID, the string name, and the complex object data that we are going to use as a data source for a table. Let's add a text box component in the details section of the report and set its value to one of the simple data source fields. The data fields are not yet available as we forgot to set the JSON data source we just created as a data source for the report. Let's do this now. The fields are now available and we can display the ID in the first text box. Make sure the expression starts with an equal sign. Let's repeat the process for the second text box that will display the field called name. We may select the two items by holding Ctrl key and change their style, for example, the background color. We need to hit apply so that it takes effect, but I will skip it here. Let's preview the report. The layout seems correct. We can now start the table wizard from the components area to lead us through the process of creating a table we will incorporate into the report. It requires a data source. However, we only have the one data source for the main report. Let's add the new JSON data source with a schema of the data field from the main data source. I have already prepared it, so I just copy and paste it in the wizard. It has three fields. Again, we start the table wizard and select the newly created JSON data source. Let's add two of the fields to the table. We purposely skip the category field as we're going to use it later for grouping the table. Select one of the built-in styles for the table. The preview is as expected. Just the same table is repeated three times. Let's now configure the table data to come from the report's main data source. We use bindings to link the data source property of the table to the data field of the report's JSON data source. Now the table displays the data for the corresponding main data record. We may add the Telerik logo to our page header in a picture box. We will use an embedded image loaded from a local folder. In the page footer, we add a text box to display the page number and count. We use the built-in page functions for this purpose. The logo is not visible as it's too big for the picture box size. We can resize it to fit. A new look at the preview to assure everything is okay. Next, we will add row groups to the table. We need to select one of the text boxes in the table body and add a parent row group. Let's add a group footer so we can display some aggregates for the group. The grouping expression is simply the category field we would like to group by. We adjust the details section height and preview again. The table data is properly grouped. let's add the group totals in the group footer. We can increase the font size and make it bold from the style menu so that they can be distinguished from the detail data. There are other styling options, for example, cell borders. Preview to assure everything is going well. We can also add grand totals for the entire table. Select the row header cell and add a new row outside of the group below the current row. Let's type the proper expressions in the new cells. We can copy the aggregate functions for the total from the group total. The evaluation scope will encompass the entire table data rather than a single table group. The preview proves everything is all right. We may play a bit more with the styling, for example, add a bottom border to the row header cell. It appears on preview. Let's also specify in the group totals what the current category is. We can use embedded expressions again. The categories are indeed displayed with the totals. Here is how the final report document looks in print preview and in interactive view mode.